Father, bless.
Blessed is our God, always now and ever, unto ages of ages.
Amen. Glory be to thee, our God. Glory be to thee. All heavenly King, Comforter, Spirit of Truth, Lord everywhere, President, fill us all things, treasury of good things, and giver of life. Come and dwell in us and cleanse us of all impurity and save our souls, O good one. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
The kingdom, the power, the glory, and the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and through ages of ages.
Amen. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship God, our King. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and God. Hearken, O Lord, unto my righteousness, attend unto my supplication. Give ear unto my prayer, which cometh not from deceitful lips. From before thy face, let my judgment come forth. Let mine eyes behold the brightness. Thou hast proved my heart, thou hast visited in the night. Thou hast tried me by fire, and unrighteousness was I found in me. That my mouth might not speak of the works of men, for the sake of the words of thy lips have I kept the ways that are hard. Set my footsteps in thy path, that my steps may not be shaken. I have cried, for thou hast hearkened unto me, O God. Incline thine ear unto me, and hearken unto my words. Let thy mercy be made wonderful, O thou that savest them that hope in thee. From them that have resisted thy right hand, keep me, O Lord, as the apple of thine eye. In the shelter of thy wings shalt thou shelter me from the face of the ungodly which have oppressed me. Mine enemies have surrounded my soul. They have enclosed themselves with their own fat. Their mouth has spoken pride. They that cast me out have now encircled me. They set their eyes to look askance on the earth. They have taken me as by a lion ready for his prey, and as by a lion's whelp that dwelleth in hiding. Arise, O Lord, overtake them and trip their heels. Deliver my soul from ungodly men, thy sword from the enemies of thy hand. O Lord, from the few do thou separate them from the earth in their life. Yea, with thy hidden treasures has their belly been filled. They have satisfied themselves with wine and left the remnants to their babes. But after me in righteousness shall I appear before thy face. I shall be filled when thy glory is made manifest to me. Unto thee, O Lord, have I lifted up my soul. O my God, in thee have I trusted. Let me never be put to shame, nor let my enemies laugh me to scorn. Yea, let none the way than thee be put to shame. Let them be ashamed which are lawless without a cause. Make the ways, O Lord, known unto me, and teach me thy paths. Lead me in the truth, and teach me, for thou art God my Savior. For on thee have I waited all the day long. Remember thy compassion, O Lord, and thy mercy, for they are from everlasting. This since my youth and my ignorance is, remember not. According to thy mercy, remember thou me, for the sake of thy goodness, O Lord. Good and upright is, O Lord, therefore he will set the law for them that sin in the way. He will guide the meek in judgment, he will teach the meek his ways. All the ways of the Lord are mercy and truth unto them that seek after his covenant and his testimonies. For the sake of the name, O Lord, be gracious unto my sin, for it is great. Who is the man that feareth the Lord? He will set him along the way which he has chosen. His soul shall dwell among good things, and his seed shall inherit the earth. The Lord is the strength of them that fear him, and his heart and multiply, bring me out from my necessities. You owe my lowliness and my toil, and forgive all my sins. Look upon my enemies, for they are multiplied, and with an unjust hatred have they hated me. Keep my soul and rescue me. Let me not be put to shame, for I have hoped in thee. The innocent and the upright have pleaded on me, for I wait on thee, O Lord. Redeemed Israel, O God, out of all his afflictions. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin, for I know mine iniquity, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and in sin did my mother bear me. For behold, thou hast loved truth, babe, and the secret things of thy wisdom hast thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness. The bones of the humble, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, O God, of all mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hast desired sacrifice, I have given it with open offerings. Thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken and humble. God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in thy good pleasure and design, and let the walls of Jerusalem be builded. Then shalt thou be pleased with a sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and open offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, go now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory be to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. By thy cross thou didst destroy death to the thief, thou didst open paradise for the murderers, thou didst change weeping into joy, and thou didst command thy disciples, O Christ God, to proclaim that thou art risen, granting the world great mercy. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. In thee, O Mother, thou which was created according to the image of God was manifestly saved. For accepting thy cross, thou didst follow after Christ, and pray, thou didst learn to sustain the flesh. For thou didst transcend it, and to take care of thine immortal soul. Wherefore, with the angels dost thou thy soul rejoice, O venerable Matrona. Both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Theotokos, thou art the true one that has blossomed forth for us the fruit of life. Thee we supplicate, and receive a lay together with the holy apostles our souls by mercy. Blessed is the Lord God, blessed is the Lord day by day, the God of our salvation shall prosper us along the way. Our God is the God of salvation. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
In the power and glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Amen. The dominion of death can no longer hold him captive, for Christ has sent his shattering and destroying his powers. Hell is bound while the prophets rejoice and cry, those in faith, enter you faithful into the resurrection. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Thou who at all times and at every hour in heaven and on earth are worshipped and glorified, O Christ God, who are long suffering, plenteous and mercy, most compassionate, who loveth the righteous and has mercy on sinners, who calls all to salvation through the promise of good things to come. Receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour, and guide our life for thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, make chaste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Compass about with thy holy angels that guard and guide us by their array. We may attain to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of thine unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and beyond the mere, more glorious than the seraphim, who without corruption gave his birth to God the Word, the very Theotokos, and thee do we magnify. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
The Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.
Amen. O Master God, the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, one Godhead, one power, have mercy on me, a sinner, and by the judgment which thou knowest, save me, thine unworthy servant, for blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship God, our King. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and God. O God, in thy name save me, and in thy strength do thou judge me. O God, hearken unto my prayer, give ear unto the words of my mouth. For strangers are risen up against me, a mighty man has sought after my soul, and have not set God before themselves. For behold, God help me, and the Lord is the protector of my soul. He will bring evils upon mine enemies, utterly destroy them by thy truth. Willingly shall I sacrifice unto thee. I will confess thy name, O Lord, for it is good. For out of every affliction hast thou delivered me, and mine eyes look down upon mine enemies. Give ear, O God, unto my prayer, and disdain not my supplication. Attend unto me, and hear me. I was grieved in my meditation, and I was troubled at the voice of him, and at the oppression of the sinner, because it turned iniquity upon me, and put wrath for the angry against me. My heart is troubled within me, and the terror of death has fallen upon me. Fear coming come upon me, and darkness has covered me. And I said, who will give me wings like a dove, and I will fly and be at rest. Lo, I have fled off and dwelt in the wilderness. I waited for God to save me from faintheartedness and from tempest. Cleanse them into depths, O Lord, and divide their tongues. For I have seen iniquity and gazing in the city. Day and night they go round about upon the walls. Iniquity and trial and unrighteousness are written in this letter. And usury and deceit are not departed from her streets. For if my enemy have befouled me, I might have endured it. And if he had hated me and spoken boastful words against me, I might have hid myself from him. But thou wast, O man of us, only my God and my familiar friend. Thou who together me to sweeten my repast. In the house of God I walk with thee in oneness of mind. Let death come upon the tongue, and let them down alive to the ladies. For wickedness is in their dwellings and in the midst of them. As of me unto God I cried, and the Lord hearken unto me. Any more in the name will I tell of it, and will declare it, and he will hear my voice. He will redeem my soul in peace, and then they come nigh unto me. For they are among men who are with me. God will hear when he will humble them, he did before the ages. For to them there is no requital, because they have not feared God. He stretched forth his hand in retribution. They have defiled his covenant, they were scattered by the wrath of his countenance, and hearts have been beaten. The words were smoother than oil, and yet they are darts. Cast a care upon the Lord. overshadowed thee, and under his wings shalt thou hope. With the shield, with the truth and compass thee, thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor of the arrow of the fire by day, nor of the thing, nor of the darkness, nor of the mist, and even at noonday. 8,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but unto thee shall not come nigh. Only with thine eye shalt thou behold, and thou shalt see the reward of sinners. But for thou, Lord, art my help, thou madest the Most High thy refuge. No evil shall come nigh thee, and no spirit shall come nigh unto thy dwelling. For he shall give thee into charge of his people, to keep thee in all thy ways. All the hands that shall thee up, blessed at any time that thou set foot against the stone. Upon the ass and back shall shall their head, and thou shalt crop upon the lion and dragon. For he has said so, and I will deliver him. O shelter, because he knows my name. He shall come unto me, and I will hearken unto him. I have written in affliction, and I will rescue him and glorify him. Will lengthen his life, satisfy him, and I will show him my salvation. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory be to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory be to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory be to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. By thy cross, thou didst destroy death to the thief, thou didst open paradise for the murderers, thou didst change weeping into joy, and thou didst command thy disciples, O Christ God, to proclaim that thou art risen, granting the world great mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Thy martyrs, O Lord, in their sufferings have received imperishable crowns from thee, our God. For possessed of thy might, they set in rock the tormentors and destroy the people, the audacity of the demons. By their prayers save thou our souls. Go now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Seeing that we have no boldness on account of our many sins, do thou beseech us, O born of thee, O virgin, to help us for the supplication of a mother. Avail this much to win the master's favor. Disdain of the prayers of sinners, O all here one, for merciful and mighty to save this evening, also to suffer for our sins. Let that compassion quickly go before the Lord, for we have become exceedingly poor. Help us, O God, a Savior, for the sake of the glory of thy name. O Lord, deliver us and be gracious unto our sins for thy name's sake. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now forever and to ages of ages.
Amen. The dominion of death can no longer hold the captive, for Christ is sent to shattering and destroying his powers. Hell is bound while the prophets rejoice and cry. The Savior has come to those in faith. Enter ye faithful into the resurrection. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Thou who at all times and at every hour in heaven and on earth are worshipped and glorified, O Christ God, who are most offering, plenteous of mercy, most compassionate, who lovest the righteous and has mercy on sinners, who calls all to salvation through the promise of good things to come, receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour and guide our life for thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, may change our bodies, correct our thoughts, give our intentions, and deliver us from every from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Come to the bow with thy holy angels that guard and guide by their array. We may attain to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of an unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. For all the cherubim and beyond, compare more glorious than the seraphim, without corruption, gave his word to God the Word, the very theotokos of thee, do we magnify. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Through the prayers, O Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.
Amen. O God and Lord of hosts and maker of all creation, who by the tender compassion of thy mercy, which transcendeth comprehension, did send down the only begotten Son of Lord Jesus Christ for the salvation of our race, and by his precious cross did tear asunder the handwriting of our sins, and thereby did triumph over the principalities and powers of darkness. Do thou thyself, O Master, lover of mankind, accept also from us sinners the prayers of thanksgiving and entreaty, and deliver us from every destructive and dark transgression, and from all enemies, both visible and invisible, that seek to do us evil. Now down the flesh with the fear of thee, and incline not hearts and the words of thoughts of evil, but pierce us all with longing for thee, so that ever looking to thee and being guided by thy light, as we behold thee, the unapproachable and everlasting light, we may send up unceasing praise and thanksgiving unto thee, the unoriginate Father, with an only begotten Son, and the all holy and good and life creating Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Church of some kind and the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy temple and for them that with faith, reverence, and the fear of God and to him, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our great Lord and Father, His Holiness, Patriarch Hill, for our ordinary most reverend Metropolitan Elarion, first hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, for our Lord and most reverend Archbishop Gideon, for the venerable priesthood and the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the North, preserve the Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may deliver his people from enemies, both visible and invisible, and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the soul and its authorities, and all in faith and piety dwell therein, and in every land, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the city, for every city and country, and the faithful that dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonal and abundance of the fruits of the earth in peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For traveled by sea, land, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the imprisoned, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Oh, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our cause.
To thee, O God.
Reverend, our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos and the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our cause.
To thee, O Lord.
For thine is the dominion, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and ever, and ever.
Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord in my life. I will chant unto my God as long as I have my being. Trusting not in princes and the sons of men, in whom there is no salvation. His spirit shall go forth, and he shall return unto his earth. In that day all his thoughts shall perish. Blessed is he who is of the God of Jacob, and his help, whose hope is in the Lord his God, who hath made heaven and the earth, the sea and all that is therein, who keepeth through the two eternity, who are secured in judgment for the wrong, who giveth food unto the hungry. The Lord looseth the fetter, the Lord maketh wise the blind, the Lord set at the right the fallen, the Lord loveth the righteous. The Lord preserveth the proselytes, he shall adopt for us on the orphan and widow, and the wicked sinner shall he destroy. The Lord shall be king unto eternity, the God of Zion unto generation and generation. Both now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. O only begotten Son and Word of God, who art immortal, yet distinct for salvation, to be incarnate of the Holy Theotokos and of a Virgin Mary, and without change is become that, and was crucified, O Christ God, trembling and death by death. Thou art one of the Holy Trinity, glorified with the Father and the Holy Spirit. Save us.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, hear us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord,
and to remembrance, now most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, never Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another, and all our life unto Christ our cause.
Remember us, O Lord, Thou who dost ever protect the Theotokos, now
By night.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Master, the bringer of the good tidings, of the holy apostle, and evangelist,
Lord, have mercy.
great Lord and Father, His Holiness Patriarch Kirill, for our Lord, the very most reverend Metropolitan Hilarion, first Hierarch of the Latin Church of Rome, and for our Lord, the most reverend Archbishop Kirill, and for all our brethren in Christ.
Lord have mercy.
Again, we pray for the God preserved Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation.
Lord have mercy.
Again, we pray to the Lord our God that He may deliver His people from enemies both visible and invisible, and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety.
Lord have mercy.
And we pray for this, our land, its authorities, and all who in faith and piety dwell therein, and in every land.
Lord have mercy.
And we pray for our brethren, the priests, monks, and all our brethren in Christ.
Lord have mercy.
And we pray for the blessed and ever memorable holy Orthodox patriarchs, for pious kings and right believing queens, and for the founders of this holy temple, and for our fathers and brethren gone to their rest before us, and the Orthodox here and everywhere laid to rest.
Lord have mercy.
O physician of souls and bodies, with compunction and broken in heart, we fall down before Thee, and with groaning we cry unto Thee. Do Thou heal the sicknesses and cure the passions of the souls and bodies of Thy servants, Hieros, Chema, Monk, Ambrose, Archpriest John, Archpriest Seraphim, Hieromonks, Trifon, Abbot, Priest Yuan, Protodeacon George, Deacon George, Christiani, Dimpha, John, Alexander, Nicholas, Nikolai, Nina, Marina, Marina, Constantine, Vera, Barbara, Anna, Child, Maria, Helen, Ariadna, Rossi, Alexandra, Victor, Child, Iliana, and as Thou art compassionate, forgive them every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary, and quickly raise them up from the bed of sickness. We pray Thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Giving thanks with fear and trembling as unprofitable servants unto Thy loving kindness, O Lord, our Savior and Master, for Thy benefits which Thou hast poured out abundantly on Thy servants, we fall down in worship and offer a doxology unto Thee as God, and fervently cry aloud to Thee, deliver Thou Thy servants from all misfortune, and as Thou art merciful, always fulfill the desires of us all unto good. We diligently pray Thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
O Lord, who didst most gloriously deliver Joseph from the animosity of his brethren, and didst lead him to Egypt, and through the blessing of Thy goodness didst make him to prosper in all things, bless also these Thy servants who desire to travel, our priest Andrew and all his family, Nadia and Caleb, and cause their journey to be safe and tranquil. We pray Thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
More than all others, we have sinned against Thee, and we have transgressed our character, and if we have not acquired repentance, instead of the repentance, accept our offering. And having set thyself to mercy, as thou art almighty, free thy servants from death, bearing sickness and grievous afflictions, groaning in pain, we pray thee. Quickly hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray to our Lord and Savior that he may preserve the Orthodox Church throughout the world in unity and piety, and grant unto her peace and tranquility, love and accord. Let us all say, O Lord, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray that he may look down upon the Holy Orthodox Church with kindheartedness and mercy, and preserve her from divisions and schisms, from enmity and strife, that her unity might neither be diminished nor shaken, but that thy Christ's holy name might be glorified. Let us all say, O Lord, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Furthermore, we pray to the Lord our God that he will cover with his divine wings the holy city of Jerusalem and all our brethren and sisters abiding in the Holy Land, in the province of Kosovo, the country of Syria, throughout the Near East and the Ukrainian lands, that their holy places and homes may be preserved from destruction and defilement, and that he may grant to his faithful children a tranquil and peaceful life in all piety and purity.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for them that bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for them that minister and them that chant, and for all the people here present, that we will be great and abundant mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, we are now, beloved and kind, and unto thee we send our glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Pray, you catechumens, to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
He is faithful for the catechumens. Let us pray that the Lord will have mercy on us. Let us pray to the Lord. wrath and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord have mercy.
Wisdom.
Thank you. Thank you.
let us stand well. Let us stand with fear, let us attend, that we may offer the holy oblation in peace.
Thank you.
Especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, ever Virgin Mary.
To thee, O
let's sing to the Lord.
To thee, O Lord.
Through the grace and compassions and love for mankind of thy only begotten Son, with whom art blessed, together with that most holy good and thy drinking spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of the ages.
Let us attend.
Holy things are for the holy.
What is holy? What is Lord Jesus Christ? To the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Conversion, but thou hast said, O love for mankind through thy prophet. of destruction of men, but desires that all be saved and come to knowledge of the truth. Wherefore, even I, although unworthy of heaven and earth and of this temporal life, having submitted my whole self to sin and made myself a slave of pleasure, and having defaced thine image, yet being thy work and creation, wretched though I be, I despair not of my salvation, and dare to approach thine immeasurable loving kindness. Accept then even me, O Lord, lover of mankind, as thou didst accept the sinful woman, the thief, the publican, and the prodigal, and take away the heavy burden of my sins. Thou that takest away the sin of the world, and healest the infirmities of mankind, who callest the weary and heavy laden unto thyself, and givest them rest, who camest not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance, and do thou cleanse me from all defilement of flesh and spirit, and teach a deep holiness in the fear of thee, that with the pure testimony of my conscience, receiving a portion of thy holy things, I may be united unto thy holy body and blood, and have thee living and abiding in me with the Father and thy Holy Spirit. Yea, O Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not the communion of thine immaculate and life-giving mystery be unto me for judgment, neither unto infirmity of soul and body, because of my partaking of them unworthily. But grant me until my last breath to receive without condemnation the portion of thy holy things, unto communion with the Holy Spirit as a provision for life eternal, for unacceptable defense at the bread judgment seat, so that I also with all the elect may become a partaker of thine incorruptible blessings, which thou hast prepared for them to love thee, O Lord, and who thou glorified unto the ages. Amen. O Lord my God, I know that I am not worthy or sufficient that thou shouldest enter beneath the roof of the temple of my soul, for all is empty and fallen, and thou hast thy envious place worthy to lay thy head. But as from on high thou dost humble thyself for sake, do thou also, O Lord, thyself to my lowliness, and as thou didst consent to lie in a cave in a manger of dumb beasts, so consent also to lie in a manger of my irrational soul, and to enter into my defiled body. And as thou did not refuse to enter and to dine with sinners in the house of Simon the leper, so did also to enter into the house of my lowly soul, leprous and sinful. And as thou did not reject the harlot and sinner like me when she came and touched thee, so be compassionate also and be a sinner as I approach and touch thee. And as thou didst feel no loathing for the defiled and unclean lips of her that kissed thee, do thou also no loathe my defiled lips, nor mine abominable and impure mouth and my polluted and unclean tongue. But let the fire recall of thy most holy body and thy precious blood be unto me for sanctification and enlightenment and health from my lowly soul and body, unto the lightening of the burden of my many sins, for preservation from every act of the devil, for the expulsion and prohibition of my evil and wicked habits, unto the mortification of the passions, unto the keeping of thy commandments, unto the application of thy divine grace, unto the acquiring of thy kingdom. For not with disdain do I approach, O Christ God, but as one trusting in thine ineffable goodness, and that I may not by much abstaining from thy communion become the prey of the spiritual wolf. Wherefore do I entreat thee, for thou the only holy one, O Master, sanctify my soul and body, my mind and heart, my belly and my inward parts, and renew me entirely, and implant thy fear in my members, and make thy sanctification inalienable from me, and be unto me a helper and defender, guiding my life in peace, vouchsafing me also to stand at thy right hand with thy saints, through the intercessions and supplications of thy most pure mother, of thine image and ministry. through the assumption of our nature, to take upon thyself thy life-giving and saving passion, the cross, the nails, the spear, and death, mortify the soul-corrupting passions of my body. Thou who by thy burial didst see captive the kingdom of Hades, bury wicked thoughts by evil schemes and destroy the spirits of evil. Thou who by thy life-bearing resurrection on the third day didst raise up our fallen forefather, raise me up who has sat down into sin, setting before me the ways of repentance. Thou who by thy most glorious ascension to deify the flesh that thou hast taken, and is honored with a seat at the right hand of the Father, vouchsafe me through partaking of thy holy mysteries to attain a place at thy right hand among them that are saved. Thou who by the descent of thy Spirit the Comforter didst make the holy disciples worthy vessels, show me also to be a receptacle of his coming. Thou who art to come again to judge the world in righteousness, deign to let me also meet thee on the clouds, my judge and creator, with all thy saints, that I may endlessly glorify and praise thee with thine unoriginate Father, and the most holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Master, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, who alone has authority to remit the sins of men, do thou, as the good one and lover of mankind, overlook all my offenses, whether committed with knowledge or in ignorance, and vouchsafe me to partake without condemnation of thy divine, glorious, immaculate, and life-giving mysteries, not for a burden, nor for punishment, nor for an increase of sins, but unto purification and sanctification, and as a pledge of the life and kingdom to come, as a bulwark and help for the destruction of enemies, and for the blotting out of my many transgressions. For thou art a God of mercy and compassion and love for mankind, and unto thee we send a glory with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. I know, O Lord, that I partake unworthily of thine immaculate body and thy precious blood, and that I am guilty and even bring damnation to myself, not discerning the body and blood of thee, my Christ and God, but taking courage in thy compassion, I approach in thee.
Wherever I believe this is truly thy most pure body, and this is truly thine precious blood. Wherever I pray thee, have mercy on me, and forgive me my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and deed, known and unknown. Vouchsafe me to partake without condemnation thy most pure mysteries, and to the remission of my sins and life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, receive me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of the mystery to thine enemies. Neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss, but like the thief do I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. Let not the communion of thy holy mysteries be unto me for judgment or condemnation, O Lord, but unto the healing of soul and body. Amen.
Thank you.
bride, having partaken of the divine, holy, most pure, immortal, heavenly and life-giving gift of mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Having asked for the whole day, that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commit ourselves and one another, and all our life unto Christ our Lord.
The Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of
ages. Amen.
Let us depart in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Oh, Lord, let us bless and that bless thee, and sanctify them that have put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thy inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify them, the love and beauty of thy house. Do thou glorify them by thy divine power. Forsake us not that hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee do we send up glory and thanksgiving and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever. And unto thee, it is all the ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord,
it's
forevermore. Let us be the name of the Lord, it's forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, it's
sickness, but a much more radical healing, her resurrection from the dead. Christ and his disciples had just returned from their visit to the country of the Gadarenes, and as the news of Christ's fame and good works was growing, they were surrounded by a multitude who awaited him, so many seeking healing and comfort. We are told that a man named Jairus, a respected ruler of the synagogue, came and fell at Jesus' feet and begged him to come to his house to heal his daughter, who was deathly ill. Jairus approached Christ with hope and faith that he could heal his only daughter and make her well. There was an urgency in his voice as he knew that she might not have long to live. Christ heard his desperate request and agreed to come to his house, promising to make his daughter well again. But before they were able to come to the house, the news reached them that Jairus' daughter had died. There was no longer any need to trouble the master, for all hope was lost. But when Jesus heard the news of his death, he answered, saying, "Do not be afraid, only believe, and she will be made well." Christ enters the home and insists that the child is not dead, but only sleeps. All the mourners assembled mocked him, and yet he enters the room of the dead child, and at his life-giving word, he restores her to life and to health. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, how providential that we hear this gospel today. For this is a gospel of hope in the face of darkest circumstances and of seeming hopelessness. We find ourselves today once again faced with the closing of our churches. I know that this is a bitter and sorrowful trial for us all, and the situation is not made any easier by the debate on how questionable these lockdowns are as a response to the spread of the virus. Nevertheless, we are faced with these mandates, and we will have to navigate our way through them, attending to doing the best we can for the physical and the spiritual health of our community. For now, we must go back to live streaming and the services, and I can assure you also that Father Andrew and I will do everything that we can to minister the sacraments to you during this time. We are moving into the winter months, and I expect that things with this virus will go from bad to worse for a while. The lockdown restrictions being forced upon so many businesses and the isolation of people from one another, especially as we move into the Thanksgiving and Christmas holiday seasons. Such isolation will surely create even greater waves of depression and frustration among many people. And as if these things were not enough, we're also seeing tremendous tensions within our society as a result of the elections. It is a trying time for our nation, for our communities, for our parish, for our families, and for each of us as individuals. And so how should we as Orthodox Christians respond to all of this? Let us take our lesson from today's gospel. Let us think of poor Jairus, who so urgently and desperately sought the help of our Lord Jesus Christ to save his sick daughter, and whose home was now filled with mourners who wailed lamentations for his dead child. He surely must have felt that all hope was lost, but Christ overcame that hopelessness, just as he had in so many occasions. Recall also the disciples on their boat on the sea. On more than one occasion, they found themselves among stormy waters, and the waves crashed against their boat, and it seemed that all would be lost. On one occasion, Christ was there, peacefully sleeping at the helm of the boat. When awakened, he simply spoke a word, and the storm was calmed. On another occasion, he walked upon the waters to his beloved ones, and calmed the seas once again. My dearest brothers and sisters in Christ, the devil and the world are sending waves to crash against the vessel of our faith. Church life is once again disrupted and destabilized. Our world is living in the fear of this pandemic. Our nation is living through times of incredible instability and challenge. It is very easy to find ourselves losing hope and becoming weary and exhausted from the anxieties of the day. But how will we respond? Will the stormy waters drag us down, or will we keep our eyes focused on Christ? Because if we do retain our focus, we can even walk upon the stormy waves as if they were dry land. We have to have confidence and know who is truly in charge of all things. It is Christ our Lord. If we have to endure some trials and tribulations for a time, well, then let us endure those trials in a manner that does not threaten or weaken our faith, but that calls us to arms. Now is the time to deepen our prayers, to be at attention spiritually, to see the reality of what is going on. As we are faced with greater instability in this world, let us create stability in our life through greater attention to our daily prayers, reading the scriptures, and always nourishing our soul. God grant that each one of us can be a little candle of hope for ourselves and for those around us. And how do we give birth to this hope? What are the two virtues that the Holy Church ties so closely to hope? Faith and love. Faith and love are required if we are to have the humility and the courage to dare to hope. We have to have faith in God's ability to make possible the impossible. And we must have love, knowing first of all how much God has loved us, and with grateful hearts extending our love back to him. Let us stand aright, let us stand well, let us attend to the things of God. Let us stubbornly cling to hope. Let us take our lead from our Lord Jesus Christ, who boldly and with great faith ignored the cynical mockery of those who, quote unquote, knew better, of those who believed in death. The pessimism and the mockery of this world gained strength day by day, but this world desperately needs those who will retain their faith and their hope and their love. For these are the pillars upon which everything good is supported. God grant us the strength and the courage to hope against hope and to place all things in the capable hands of our Lord. Amen. Blessed is our God, always, now and ever, unto the ages of ages. Second song, God is the Lord, and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. O give thanks unto the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever.
God is the Lord, and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord.
Surrounding me, they compass me, and by the name of the Lord I warded them all. I shall not die, but live, and I shall tell of all the works of the Lord.
God is the Lord, and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord.
The stone which the builders rejected, the same has become that of the corner. This is the Lord's doing, it is marvelous in our eyes.
God is the Lord, and hath appeared unto us.
Upon us, O God, according to the great mercy, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Remember that we are flesh, O Lord, whose breath, when it departs, shall not return, and mercifully cast aside thy wrath, but that has justly taken hold of us, by which, as with a sword, thou hast grievously visited us. Do thou set right the pain and appease the wounds that suddenly are destroying us. For the dead do not praise thee, neither all them that have descended into Hades, but we, the living, praise thee, and groaning with pain in our hearts, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
O thou who desirest not the death of sinners, but rather that they should return to thee and live, spare and have mercy on thy servants, O merciful one. Banish sickness, drive away all passions and all ailments, assuage chill and fever, stretch forth thy mighty arm, and as thou dost raise up Jairus' daughter from the bed of sickness, restore them to health. We pray thee, O Lord, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for all the brethren and for all Christians.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Hearken unto us, O God, our Savior, the hope of all the ends of the earth, and of them that be afar off upon the sea. And be merciful, O Master, regarding our sins, and have mercy on us. For thou art a merciful God, the lover of mankind, and unto thee we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
With compunction and on bended knees, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord our God, look down from thy holy heaven on the supplication of us, thy sinful and unworthy servants, who have angered thy graciousness by our transgressions, and have provoked thy deep compassion. Enter not into judgment with thy servants, but do thou turn aside thy fearsome anger that justly has seized us. Appease the destructive threatening, avert thy terrible sword, that although invisible is cutting us grievously, spare thy poor and needy servants. Enclose not with death the souls of us who have fallen down in repentance with broken hearts and tears before thee, our kind-hearted, condescending, and accommodating God. For thine it is to show mercy and to save us, O our God. And unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory be to you, O Christ, our God, and glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, all now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Amen.
Holy Christ, our true God, who rose from the dead, through the intercession of the Salvator, Mother of the Holy Glorious, and all praise the apostles, of our Holy Father, and Wedderburger, Herman of Alaska, of the modern Onesiphorus and Porphryius of Ephesus, Venerable Matrona of Constantinople, and all those saints whose memories we celebrate today, of our Father and the Saints John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, our Holy Hierarch John Shanghai in San Francisco, the Holy Righteous Ancestors of God, Yochimanan, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind.
Amen.
Cyril Bobarikin, Misha Kosachenko, Nadia Michaela Ngrianu, Aidan Gabriel Dragomir, Gabriela Gliga, Cecilia Severnescu, Mihai Poplachinel, and celebrating her birthday, Valentina Abrabzova, and their anniversaries, Father Deacon Paul and Kathy Kosachenko, and Gabriela and Alex Gliga. Let's sing many years to all the celebrants.
A prosperous and peaceful life, health and salvation and good success in all things. Grant, O Lord, to thy servants, Cyril, Michael, Nadia, Michaela, Gabriel, Gabriel, Cecilia, Valentina, Deacon Paul, Catherine, Alexandru, Mihai, and preserve them for many years.
God grant you many years. God grant you many years. Grant you many, many years. God grant you many years. God grant you many years. Grant you
our God, glory to thee, our God, glory to thee, our God.
I thank thee, O Lord, my God, that thou hast not rejected me, a sinner, but hast thou saved me to be a communicant of thy holy things. I thank thee that thou hast thou set me the unworthy to partake of thy most pure and heavenly gifts. But, O Master, love for a mankind who forsake his die and his rise again, and his bestow upon us his dread and life-giving mysteries. For the well-being and sanctification of our souls and bodies, grant that these may be even unto me for the healing of both soul and body, for the averting of everything also, for the enlightenment of the eyes and my heart, for the peace of the powers of my soul, for faith unashamed, for love unfeigned, for the fullness of wisdom, for the keeping of thy commandments, for the increase of thy divine grace, and for the attainment of thy kingdom, that being preserved by them in thy holiness, I may always remember thy grace, and no longer live for myself, but for thee, our Master and Benefactor. And thus, when I shall have departed this life in hope of life eternal, body and for the communion of thy most pure life-giving mysteries. I pray thee, therefore, O good one and lover of mankind, keep me under thy protection and in the shadow of thy wings, and grant me even until my last breath to partake worthily with a pure conscience of thy holy things unto the remission of sins and life eternal. For thou art the bread of life, the source of holiness, the giver of good things, and unto thee we send the glory together with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O thou who givest me willingly thy flesh as food, thou who art fire and dost consume the unworthy, burn me not, O my Creator, but rather enter into my members, into all my joints, my reins, my heart. Burn up the thorns of all my sins, purify my soul, sanctify my thoughts, strengthen my substance together with my bones, enlighten my simple five senses, now down the whole of me with thy fear, ever protect, preserve, and keep me from every soul corrupting deed and word, purify and cleanse and adore me, make me comely, give me understanding and enlighten me, show me to be the dwelling place of thy spirit alone and no longer the habitation of sin. That from me as thine abode through the entry of communion, every evil doer, every passion may flee as from fire. As intercessors I offer unto thee all the saints, the commanders of the bodiless host, thy forerunner, the wise apostles, and further thine undefiled pure mother, whose entreaty do thou accept, O my compassionate Christ, and make thy servant a child of light. For thou alone art our sanctification, O good one, and the radiance of our souls. And unto thee, as God and Master, we all send a glory as is meet every day. O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, may thy holy body be unto me for life eternal, and thy precious blood for the remission of sins. And may this Eucharist be unto me for joy, health, and gladness, and at thy breath I can come thee by way of sinner to stand at the right hand of thy glory through the intercessions of thy most pure mother and of all the saints. O most holy Lady Theotokos, light of my darkened soul, my hope, protection, refuge, consolation, my joy, I thank thee that thou hast vouchsafed me, who am unworthy, to be a partaker of the most pure body and precious blood of thy Son. O thou who gavest birth to the true life, do thou enlighten the spiritual eyes of my heart. Thou who gavest birth to the source of immortality, revive me when dead in sin. Thou who art the lovingly compassionate mother of the merciful God, have mercy on me and grant me compunction and contrition in my heart and humility in my thoughts and the recall of my thoughts from captivity. And thou save me until my last breath to receive without condemnation the sanctification of the most pure mysteries for the healing of both soul and body. And grant me tears of repentance and confession with which to him and glorify thee all the days of my life. For blessed and most glorified art thou unto the ages. Amen. Now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, O Master, according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all peoples, a light of revelation for the Gentiles and the glory of thy people Israel. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, and we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
In the power and glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Grace shining forth from the mouth like a beacon has illumined the universe and disclosed to the world treasures of uncommon essential insights of humility. But while instructing by the words of Father John Chrysostom, intercede with the word Christ our God to save our souls. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. From the heavens hast thou received the divine grace, and by thy lips dost thou teach all to worship the one God in Trinity. O John Chrysostom, O blessed righteous one, rightly do we acclaim thee, for thou art a teacher revealing things divine, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O protection of Christians that cannot be but their shame, O mediation unto the Creator unfailing, disdain of the salty of voices of sinners, but be the first of good unto us who in faith cry unto thee, hasten to intercession and speed up to make supplication. Thou dost ever protect us, they are those them that honor thee. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim and beyond comparable glorious than the seraphim, who without